nothing. I just... It's just been a weird day.
Perhaps for you, but for me, this is every day. Except Wednesdays. I like to rest on a Wednesday.
But... The 4th of September, 1985. The day we set off from... Was a Wednesday. You said.
Sometimes I make exceptions.
I was an exception, eh?
You needed help. Besides, I technically met you on the Sunday. Very early Sunday, it just stopped being Saturday.
You know what I said before? About not just being a one-trip wonder.
Uh-huh.
I didn't mean it. I think I've seen enough now.
The Daleks scared you. Won't judge, they scare me too.
I know they do. And that scares me. I've seen what they do to you. What they make you become, and that is terrifying.
I'm really, truly sorry that you had to witness me like that.
Just promise me that when we go our separate ways, you won't just pick up some other girl and use her as a bargaining chip for your personal vendettas. Nobody deserves that.
I can never apologise enough for what I did. But you were always going to be safe.
Oh, you're so full of yourself. You had no idea that I'd be safe. I could have died. What are you doing? What are you looking at me like that for?
We're taking a break.
No, you're getting me home.
Look out of those doors. Just do it.
I'll be sucked out into space.
No, it's fine. The gravity shell's extended.
It's just dark. And there's a planet. Yes, it's pretty. Yes, it's pretty ace. But if this is your way of trying to change my mind, it's not working.
There's a paradox out there. Ripping through time and space, slowly eating away at the fabric of our entire existence.
So what? You can sort it without me.
I don't think I can.
You better had.
Excuse me, Miss Attitude.
Take me home now!
I landed on your lap. Not literally, but I landed with you. Just after I escaped a Rothlack ship. You lost everything. We fixed it, but Zell, he said...
That the Rothlacks went to war with Parthaxis.
Same Rothlacks whose ship I was on.
Coincidence.
I really hoped it might have been, but I'm not sure anymore.
Like I care. Just take me home, or I'll call the police.
That's not gonna work. The phone isn't connected to the police. And if it was, do you think they'd really believe you if you said you were stranded several billion light years from Earth, floating above an alien planet in the far future?
No.
You had so much potential, Sophie.
Potential? Potential what?
You, me, time and space. You could have been the perfect companion. Tough, brave, strong enough to stand on your own two feet and not afraid to answer back.
Yeah. Well, I've got to leave you. And this is me being tough, brave, strong enough to stand on my own two feet and not afraid to answer back.
I'll miss you, Sophie Stevens. Shame we didn't get to know each other better.
No, oh, I think I got to know you well enough.
Why, thank you.
Like I said, back with the Daleks, I can't help but trust you, and I can't take that risk. You said I shouldn't have faith in you. What if one day you failed and I got hurt? Can't risk that. Not now my family are back.
It's all right. I understand and respect that decision.
How long till we're back?
Should be there any minute.
What just happened? Is that normal?
No, not quite.
Is it bad?
Yeah, we should be dead.
What do you mean, should be?
The engines have shut down. We should be falling.
But we're not. At least I don't think we are. This doesn't feel like falling.
Exactly. We're stuck.
And that's bad.
Imagine it's a little bit like being on a roller coaster when it breaks down on the upside down bit.
So we're literally frozen in midair?
I think so.
And we're upside down. I mean, how do you even know that?
The gravity field makes it impossible to tell if we're upside down or right way up. It just sounds more fun that way.
But whether we're upside down or not, we're frozen. We're stuck. What could even be out there that could have done this to us?
Paradox.
You don't think it's the paradox. It can't be following us. We just left it back in Skaro.
That was just one part of it. The cataclysm that caused it, at whatever point in my future, ripped through time and space. It shattered the very bonds of reality, seeping through anywhere it can, infecting the universe. Anything's possible, and we have no idea how fast or how far it's spread.
So, it's all over. All time. All space.
Yeah. And if I don't find out where it comes from, eventually it'll consume everything. The universe just ceases to exist. Even me. Before I even have a chance to get to the cause of it.
Well done, Doctor. But it might not be the paradox. It could be anything, right?
Let's find out, shall we?
I just want to go home.
Come here, Sophie. Look at this.
I can't see. The light's too bright. What is it? The sun?
Don't be ridiculous, girl. The sun's heat would have frazzled us in less than a second at this proximity, no matter what protection I put up. No, this isn't a sun. We haven't moved from where we were. This is a tractor beam.
A tractor beam? Really?
Really? And it's coming from down there.
Where exactly is there?
I don't know.
Always know.
She's not responding. I can't even find out where we are this time. The only thing I know is that this means there's someone or something down there on that planet. Someone or something that wants us to go to them.
Can't we just dematerialise back to my house?
No.
Why?
Because the tractor beam is interfering with the TARDIS mechanics and it's frozen the time rotor.
But you promised you were going to get me home.
I did, and I still do. But right now, there's nothing we can do, so one more adventure?
No, you said you'd take me home.
We're stuck in a tractor beam and all you care about is going home still.
This is the second time you've captured me in the same day. Does this happen to you a lot?
No, it doesn't actually. You're just bad luck. Probably karma's still coming after you. What did you do to annoy her?
You still think this is karma?
Must be. You're bringing me all your bad luck. Sophie Stevens, the unluckiest girl in existence. You sure you didn't upset a creepy kid at school or smash a mirror or spit on a gypsy?
Spit on a gypsy?
That's how you get cursed.
Thought you didn't believe in curses.
I don't, but anything can happen, right?
No, I haven't done any of those things. Wait, why would you think I would spit on a gypsy?
I don't know. It's nice to know you're a good girl and wouldn't spit on someone. I might just keep you, unless you are bringing me this bad luck.
Don't start. I am not a possession and you are not keeping me.
Like I said before, I picked up on a trace of paradox energy that turned out not to exist. Almost got myself killed. Had a Rothlack jump out of my TARDIS into the time vortex rather than face the possibility of a paradox existing. And then I landed with you. Only to find out soon after that there actually is a paradox out there. Why, of all time and space, did I get dumped with you?
Dumped? You make me feel like a burden. But the thing is, if you just get me home, I won't be anymore.
It's your bad luck that keeps getting us captured.
Oi! You're the pilot of this thing. Don't you just have shields you could put up or something?
They were up when Davros managed to hack into the system, and that was impossible to say the least.
But it happened.
I don't know how. But oi! Don't you question my piloting skills. They're more than adequate. I'd like to see you try.
So I take it we're staying here then?
I don't like tractor beams. Never have. Don't like being forced to do stuff. I stole this TARDIS for the freedom, you know, to get away from being told what to do.
Now you're just...
Sophie!
Departure was written by Simon Sayers Franklin. It starts Simon Sayers Franklin as the Doctor and Emma Ward as Sophie Stevens.